Once this woman came to see me for a soul retrieval session because she had been ingesting peyote for a long time. And she told me that she had erroneously thought that it was just good for everyone. And so if anybody had a problem, she said, oh, have some peyote and you'll feel better. Well, one day she gave it to a friend. And when she gave it to this friend, a demon popped out of her. And the woman started hopping up and down and started running around like a mad woman. And her face became this demon face and her eyes became these demon eyes. And when you're looking into a demon's eyes, you know. When you're looking at someone that's been drinking heavily, for example, you can see that demon in their eyes. So when people are ingesting and taking these things, you can see the dark force that is now there, present very strongly. So the woman was so scared, the first woman, the woman that gave the friend the peyote, she was so scared, and luckily for her, the possessed woman ran out of her house, and this lady then came, the one that gave the friend the peyote, she came to see me, and she was crying, because something also entered into her. And when this happens, you feel violated. Severely violated, painfully violated, and all you can do is cry. Another woman in Australia had the same experience. She took something like ayahuasca, or maybe it was ayahuasca. And she went into a realm, and in that realm, she was attacked by a dark force. And then she passed out, and then when she woke up, all she knew was that her soul was in pain. She could feel that her soul was in pain. She could feel that in her solar plexus, something had attached. And then now it was draining from her. It was pulling, sucking energy from her, a vampire energy. And she was miserable. A lot of people are very sensitive, and they really feel when something dark is in their aura. They'll come to me and they'll say, I know something's attached. And that's why you see imbalances. And that imbalance can be a person who's overly critical, a person who's self-loathing, someone who has a hard heart, has bitterness, has impatience. There's a whole list of ugly behavior, right? Someone who has no compassion, someone who's greedy, there's the lust demon, there's the corrupt demon, there's so many. There's the addiction demon, the worry, anxiety demon. So all of these are dark forces and they need to be removed. So soul retrieval is so important. The point is that when you have taken drugs, there's a lot that has transpired that you may or may not be aware of. I assure you, something, at least one something, is attached to you and running programs inside of you and causing behavior that is not illuminated, that is not enlightened, that is not empowering. So I encourage you to stay away from all of that. And if you cannot, then contact our center and have some sessions and then practice the beautiful holy practices such as the rattling with the sacred rattle that I talk about so much in so many videos and in the books. I use those rattles over the person. Normally when I would do a session, the person would be sitting in a chair and then I would rattle around them and walk around them and I would sense where that dark energy is. And then I would start rattling and then I would sometimes see its face flash in my mind and I would sense it and I would sense how big it is. And when you feed an addiction demon, for example, for a long time, it's huge. Whatever your ceiling is in your home, in your abode, it's higher than that. It's bigger than that. The more you feed these dark forces, the fatter they get, the bigger they get. And the bigger they get, the more they can control you. I want to encourage you to get high with spiritual practices. You cannot overdo chanting. You cannot overdo it. You can chant day and night and you will feel so high. If you're feeling sad, if you're feeling depressed, if you're feeling rejected, a very quick way towards peace is by connecting to the grace of the universe, connecting to your spirit guides. And how do we do that? Not by ingesting this or that, where later you can crash and where later you can burn. No. It's by chanting the sacred names, the holy names, any of them, if it's Shiva, if it's Buddha, if it's Jesus, if it's Mary, if it's Tara, if it's Kali, if it's Durga, if you want to praise the archangels, praise the universe, because that's what chanting is. Praise the goodness, praise the Dharma, praise Lord Hanuman, praise Lord Ganesh. When you praise them, you invoke them and they are with you. And they can offer you solutions. They can speak into your mind and offer you guidance. They can reassure you and they can instruct you. And then you will know it's coming from the highest source. Don't settle for these dangerous excursions where you are basically just opening the door to the dark forces and saying, here I am, here's my soul. We speak a lot in the physical realm about rape and how horrible rape is. And yet, many people don't think about the fact that when you get thrown, when you get propelled, when you get catapulted into these other realms, then you are open to rape by a demon. I had a great teacher, Don Jacinto Sabchak, the one that showed me clearly about dark forces, the one that was a practicing shaman who was saving the lives of people day and night, who had the most severe cases come to him. And that was what he did since he was 14 years old. He then cleared their soul of those dark energies. That was Don Jacinto Sabchak. And that's who trained me. And that's where I gathered the knowledge and learned about these dark forces that I didn't even want to admit existed when I was younger. So I am letting you know they exist. And I'm letting you know, don't be afraid. Instead, be aware, dance, sing, be joyful, and practice some kind of spiritual path. Whatever the teacher, just make sure they're genuine, they're truly enlightened, but the practices, like standard things, like meditation, like chanting, like praying, do it as much as you can every day, every night. And follow my practices that I've outlined in the books about clearing your space and clearing yourself. And chant with the mantras I've recorded, and then you won't feel the need to go and do something that's self-destructive. Instead, you will fall more and more in love with the practices, with the peace it brings you, and therefore with your higher self. So I love you. I'm always here for you. I'm rooting for you, as are all of your divine protectors. And we look forward to chanting with you. We look forward to connecting with you through this channel. So make sure you subscribe for more teachings on all the various syndromes and conditions and the great solutions that are available. Make sure you subscribe and make sure you stay in touch. I look forward to hearing from you. So you know where to reach us at our website. And in the meantime, have a beautiful, sweet life full of goodness. Strive for purity of soul. Don't be afraid of that. Be afraid of the other stuff. Be afraid of the stuff that will suck the life out of you. And instead, go towards that which will infuse you with grace, infuse you with self-love and self-respect, and the golden qualities that you are meant to cultivate to be a leader, to be a healer, to be the brightest light that is shining your bright light for others, to uplift all sentient beings and all realities. I love you. JJ Ma, JJ Ma, JJ Ma. I am the brave heart. I am the bright light of the universe.